out before you're like, what? Who's, what's this guy doing now? So whether you like it or not, pretty soon you're going to be an outlaw if you don't bend knee to the beast system. Okay. Before I met Jesus Christ, I spent a long time, 17 years living as an outlaw, and I learned a few things. And I want to share that with you today. Okay, now, everything you're about to see and learn is for educational purposes only, and it's only demonstrative, okay? Do not go and do this. This is the disclaimer, unless your life is in jeopardy, all right? So I'm going to show you guys something. First of all, I'm going to try to put the link for this in the description. This is called a micro escape tool. It ranges from $9 to $11. These things are very thin. You can use them as a handcuff shim. If your hands are cuffed, you use this to shim the lock on the inside. But it also, I don't know if I can get on this camera, it's got a very fine diamond saw blade on it. This little guy can cut through steel or copper like a penny. You could saw a penny in half if you had an hour to do it, okay? These things are cheap. You can just put them in your belt, like, you know what I mean? Like make a slit in your belt and just slide it right in your belt like that. And no one would ever know that it's in there. Now, why am I showing you this little saw? Because now is a good time to get things like this, because when they come for you, they're going to use those plastic handcuffs. You ever seen those zip tie cuffs? And if you got your hand zip tied behind your back and you got one of these bad boys stashed in your belt, it'll be the best $9 you ever spent in your life. Amen. And I know some Christians are like, oh, brother, you're supposed to, Romans 13 says you're supposed to submit to governing authorities. And yes, amen, we are. But like Peter said in Acts chapter 5, when the Pharisees told him to stop talking about Jesus, what did Peter say? He said, shall I obey God or shall I obey man? So brothers and sisters, just like the Lord warned us in Revelation 13 that those who don't take the mark of the beast will not buy or sell, we're going to become outlaws soon. Unless we take the mark. So I want to teach you these things now while I can. We have the opportunity available because it's going to be shut down soon. I'm going to put the link for this. It's called a micro escape tool. You can put it in your belt. You can put it in your trousers. Oh, and that's a good thing. All right. When I used to run dope in Chicago, and the cops would roll us all the time. So I found out the best hiding spot in the world. Okay. Bear with me, brothers and sisters. You see this little flap on your trousers? Make an incision on the top of it right up here. And you could slide this in there and no one would ever know that it's in there. This is the best stash spot in the world. I used to run drugs and the cops would never find my drugs when I'd hide them in there. But I praise the Lord Jesus Christ. He set me free. 17 years of heroin. I've been clean and free and sober for 5 years now serving the Lord. And I'm sharing these things with you so when the day comes, you have this knowledge. It may save your life and it may allow you to testify to others whose life you saved knowing this stuff. So we have the micro escape tool. I'll put the link in this description or in the comments. I'll see how when I make the video. Okay, this is number one. If you can't get that, I'll put the link. It's like Amazon, $9 to $11. Second, I carry this little pocket kit with me everywhere I go. It just folds up. It's got some bands to keep it shut. I keep it in my back pocket or my wallet or whatever. It's got handcuff keys and shims and ties and everything you'd ever need. But this is a must-have. This is like a sort of must have. This is just a simple basic lockpick kit, pocket size, which is hard to find surprisingly. But any lockpick kit, this is going to be your main tool right here. You can make one of these very easily. So I'm just using this for demonstrative persons only. I'm not actually picking a lock, so YouTube can't do nothing. What you want to do when you do pick a lock, though, if you have to get into something, you take this as your most important tool. There's usually two sides, a big and a small. Small usually works best. You put it in the bottom and you're going to pull left. And there's a little lever in there. You'll feel it. And what that pretension does is it opens up the mechanism. Now, while you're doing that, this is going to be your second most used tool when it comes to picking locks. These come in every kit. So I got to record with one hand. This is a two-hand operation. So just imagine with me, while you're pulling on the left with that, with your left hand, with your right hand, this is called a rake. You take the rake and you push these little levers down and you'll hear them like pins, they'll click. And this could take time sometimes. If it's a high density lock, it could take, you know, up to 30, 40, 50, maybe even an hour to pick a high lock. It's all about patience and perseverance when it comes to lock picking, all right? So this has been escape and evasion. I'm thinking about starting a series on this. I don't know, pray that the Lord would give me confirmation. Because I don't want to do nothing in my flesh. But at the same time, I don't want to waste all the stuff I learned serving the devil Now that I'm serving Jesus, it might come in helpful to somebody. So please let me know what you guys think in the comments section. Above all, guys, I really want to highly recommend this. It's a micro escape tool, okay? You can pick a handcuff lock, and most importantly, you can saw through plastic restraints. When they round us up, more than likely, they'll be using those plastic restraints. Oh, yeah, one more thing I want to show you guys, too, to get. I'll see if I can get the link in the description. I got this here belt. Just looks like a regular old belt. Watch this. I call it my Bible belt. It's like a regular belt, but when you flip it over, there's a zipper on the inside, right? These things are pretty cool. I think I paid like 15 bucks for this. And I got packed full of books of the Bible. So if they arrest me and I go to a concentration camp, I can raise up and preach the gospel to the people and feed them the word of God. I got Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Revelation, and Sister Sherry even blessed me with the book of Deuteronomy in here. So I'd highly suggest if you got the money for something like this, I don't have money no more, but I used to work for a corporation who I'm not gonna even give them the glory to say their name as a package handler, and I had some money then, so I got some cool items. If you guys got money, I suggest do it now while you can because you're almost out of time. And all this information, once again, is completely useless if you do not know the Lord Jesus Christ. Everything you do is useless. You'll probably end up burning in hell. Please repent of your sin. Turn to Jesus while there's still time. I pray that you guys are blessed. This has been Escape and Evasion. I'm the Hot Man in a Minute, and may the Lord Jesus Christ bless you. Bye.